All right, so it's the first session on the data warehouse and a lot of things here we will discuss. Now, first of all, we have to understand like what is the purpose of data warehouse? Why we actually require data warehouse? Why suddenly companies are thinking about creating the data warehouse? Then what is data warehouse? Right, all those things we have to understand first of all. Now, let's talk about it. Now in this particular session we will mostly talk about everything in a presentation. We'll try to understand this through presentation. Now what is a data warehouse? So basically data warehouse is nothing but where I actually store all my data. Now question arises, why we require data warehouse? We can store in Excel also, right? We can store in a text file, we can store in the file systems. Then why this concept of data warehousing comes into picture? So to answer that, the reason for this is basically to help you understand. Suppose I have an Excel file. If I try to save the data in Excel file, then I have a limitation, right? We used a lot of Excel files in the past sessions on various topics when we spoke about Python, how to connect to the data, when we spoke about Tableau, at that time also we saw that how to connect to the data and so on. And we used file system. But there are a lot of challenges in the file system. The first is I have a limitation. I cannot able to store data more than 10 lakhs in Excel. Right? Excel has a limitation. So if I have more than 10 lakh records, now 10 lakh records is nothing if I talk about in a real-time industry experience. I worked in like 400, 500 million records. So when we are dealing with multiple data sets where Excel is not capable enough to handle that, we require something different. We require some databases. Now again, the second thing is why we require database. Let's say for example, I have a table. And I have an employee table. And I have a department table. Now in this table, I have department ID as one of the key, department ID. And I have here also department ID, one of the keys. I want to join these two tables on department ID. If I talk about, let's say, in the file system. In the file system, suppose, if I talk about the Excel file, right? So in Excel file, let's say I have a department ID 10 and I have in this sheet also department ID 10. Now, if I will remove the record from here, I remove this record. Then when I'm trying to join this table and this table, I will not able to get this 10 in this table. That means the data is corrupt now. Because I don't have the entry of department ID 10, which is present in the employee table, in the department table. So I'm not able to get the information about that department, like which department it was. So let's say by mistake, someone removed from the Excel file. Then it will throw, like it will corrupt the data. So that is one of the limitations of the file system. When I'm actually having multiple files and have multiple data, anyone can remove the data easily. And that may or that will lead to corruption of the data. So question arises, what is the solution? Then solution is nothing but the data warehouse. I have to come to the databases. I can create my data warehouse in Oracle, Teradata, Big Data. A lot of things are there. We can use various different database to create MySQL database to create data warehouse. So now what is a data warehouse? So basically a data warehouse is a system that stores data from a company's operational databases as well as external sources. Now, what does that mean? Let's take one simple retail store example. We normally go to retail store and purchase a lot of products. Now, when we are purchasing a lot of products at that point in time, we go to the counter and in the counter people are like there are a lot of people who are entering the details about what products you purchased. So that database is nothing but known as operational database because some operations are going on from there. also known as ODS, operational data source, or you can also say that POS. POS is nothing but point of sales, where the sales is actually happening, point of sales. So now from there I get the information. Now basically, let's say this is my employee who is entering the data in the machine, right? And this data goes to my data warehouse, and then I will do some analysis. So I will discuss the entire architecture, but that is how it works. Here I am adding the data. It can be in Excel file, it can be in CSV file, it can be in text file, it can be in any database. But this data, I want to actually, my main target is to move to data warehouse. This is my operational data, where I can, based on my budget, I can choose what operational database I can go for. If my budget is very less, I may open Excel file and start saving the data. That's fine. Because I cannot maintain one database here, one database in the data warehouse. That much of budget I don't have. So in that case, let's say I'm making this as a file system, and I'm making this data warehouse in Oracle, let's say. So this is my point of sales. So operational databases as well as external sources. Now let's say I have a retail store in Gurgaon. Now I want to know in my locality, which type of people are living. So I will get that data from the external data source. I'll maybe take the data from Gurgaon government, Haryana government. And then I will check what all people are actually staying in my location, so that according to that, I will put the products in my retail store. For example, let's say there are a lot of Bengalis in the location. I may have more fishes in my retail store, so that, because I know that the consumptions will be more, so I will have that. So that external sources is helping me to understand some more insights about the data. But obviously, this operational databases and external data sources, I will combine the data and put that data in single place. And this single place is nothing but data warehouse. I'm capturing the data from various different data sources and putting in a single place, so that all the relevant information will be present in my data warehouse. Data warehouse platforms are different from operational databases because they store historical information. Obviously, because data warehouse is what? Where I have the historical information as well. For example, let's say my store is running for 5 years. So I have entire data for 5 years in the data warehouse. However, if I talk about the operational, here the guy who is actually pulling all the information from the retail store, he is maintaining one operational data warehouse, ODS. Right now, this ODS will be daily basis. Every day, how much sales is happening, he is just capturing that and it is sending it to data warehouse. Once it is in data warehouse, then obviously this data is no longer required. I can remove that, no problem, because this data already available in data warehouse now. So this data I will flush, I will delete, and then from tomorrow I'll have a new data. So operational data warehouse normally consists of one day of data. However, data warehouse consists of historical data, which makes things easier for the business leader to analyze data over a specific period of time. I want to know what is my year-on-year sales. So every details is coming from data warehouse and user analyze that data. Why data warehouse is required? Because it makes the consistent data. As I mentioned, if I delete something from Excel, I will not able to track back. But in data warehouse, I will able to make sure that my data is consistent. So we'll talk about that as and when we'll process in this, like further proceed in this class. Make better decisions, improve my bottom line sales or bottom line revenue, basically. Right? Bottom line is nothing but the final profit which I'm making. So it will improve my final profit. Now, there are some characteristics of data warehouse. The characteristics are subject oriented. Now, what subject oriented means? In normal industry, we create a data warehouse based on different subjects. For example, let's say I want to create a data warehouse for my salespeople, right? So entire data warehouse will be created related to the sales data only. So it's like subject oriented, or maybe like the entire customer database where I have all the customer details. And suppose I'm creating a data warehouse for customer details. Now in customer details, I can have sales, I can have profit, I can have marketing spend and a lot of things. So customer is a big database which I am creating. So it's a subject oriented. I am dealing with the customer, so I am creating a data warehouse for customers where I will have only customer information, customer sales, customer profit, customer marketing and so on. Second is it is integrated. I can integrate the data warehouse with various different data sources. For example, my customer information coming from Excel file. My sales information coming from Oracle. My product information coming from CSV file. So I am integrating this to the data warehouse. I integrated the different sources to a data warehouse. I put all the data in the data warehouse. So that is my integrated. Time variant. Time variant means my data is actually having a various different period of time data, right? I have data for yesterday, I have data for 1 year back, I have data for 5 years back. It purely depends on how much capacity you have to store the data. Because database is also a cost. So if your budget is not very much, maybe you are okay with 2 years of data. I don't want much data. 2 years of data is fine. But let's say my budget is very huge. So in that case, maybe I can go with 10 years of data. I can store 10 years of data and I can analyze that. So it is time variant. Based on the time, we can able to do any slice of time. Let's say I want to see the sales of January 2020 or January 2015. I have data, I can do that, no problem. And finally, it is non-volatile. Basically, it is, as I mentioned, I cannot able to delete, and obviously I can delete that, but I cannot easily delete. A lot of constraints we will discuss in the future classes. So a lot of constraints are there. As a randomly, I cannot delete anything. I have to take care of that. So it's making things very easy for us. Because in Excel file, I can delete anything, I will not able to trace back. However, in the database, if I'm trying to delete something and there is a primary foreign key type of constraint, then it will not able to delete it, which we will see again, as I mentioned in the future sessions. So these are the four main characteristics of data warehouse: subject oriented, which is based on the different subject area; integrated, I can integrate with different data sources; time variant, I can have like previous periods data as well; non-volatile, it is not easy for me to delete the data, a lot of anomalies and a lot of constraints I will have to take care of. So these are the benefits of data warehouse. Now let's talk about the architecture. How data warehouse look like? Basically, you have to understand what is the architecture in real-time IT world, how the data actually flows, right? So we'll discuss each and everything here. We'll try to understand where all those things will come in, where the database comes in, where the ETL processes will come in, where the reporting comes in, where the predictive analytics comes in. We'll talk about that each in detail in this slide. So now here you can see that I already mentioned what is ODS, right? Operational data source. So I can have various ODSs, absolutely possible. Let's say here I'm saving all the customer data. Here I'm getting data from the websites. Here I'm getting data from the, let's say, apps customers are using, right? Those information I'm getting. So this is my operational data source. From this operational data source, I will pull the data to data warehouse. And that will be done by ETL. Now ETL is nothing but extract, transform, and load. I'm extracting the data from ODS. I am transforming the data. Basically, I'm making some changes in the data as per the business requirement. As a simple example, let's say I have first name and the last name. Business wants it as a name. So what we are doing, we are concatenating first name and the last name. making it as a name. So this concatenation is nothing but a transformation. I'm transforming the data. Once I am transforming the data as per the business requirement, I am loading the data to data warehouse. So all the business logics happens at this point. All the business transformations, business logics comes at this point. In data warehouse, again, we have business tables where all the business relevant informations we store. We have metadata. We'll talk about that once we'll start SQL. And we have other objects like views. We'll talk about that also once we'll start. So basically in data warehouse, it consists of a lot of different objects, which we will see as and when we'll proceed in the SQL classes. But just to understand, majority of my business data is falling in here. So in database, I will have different tables, which I'm storing in the data warehouse. Let's say I have customer table, I have product table, I have sales table, and a lot of things. Right? Different type of tables we are storing in this database. And this entire thing is data warehouse. Now, after this, there is a concept of data marts or semantic layer. Data mart is nothing but, now here I took one example of the hospital. So let's say I am getting the data from various different data sources. I am putting that data to data warehouse. And after this, I am further segregating the data into different subject area. So basically, I have entire data in the data warehouse. From there, I am having one small data base, which is nothing but OPD. All the OPD related information is present here. Let's say pharmacy data is present here. Finance data is present here, census data is present here. So basically what I'm doing is from the database, from this data warehouse, obviously this data warehouse consists of everything. We already discussed, right? We're getting the data from various different data sources. And then from here, I am segregating further so that suppose I'm a manager of OPD. I want to analyze the data for only OPD. So I don't want to hit the database directly. Instead, I will hit the OPD. So this is like a subject oriented small databases, which is nothing but data marts. So data mart is nothing but a subset of data warehouse, which can be used for further analysis or further downstream applications. For example, let's say after my data warehouse is created, I have this OPD data. From this OPD data, I want to process, let's say billing. I want to do some billing. So some application is going on of billing, right? That application is actually fetching the data from OPD. So this application billing is fetching the data from OPD, which is a data mart, which is actually getting the data from data warehouse. But you will think now, we have data coming from here. Here, let's say I have OPD data. Here I have patient data. Here I have census data. Then why we are segregating again? Because it's a very raw format. Some business logic I applied, right? That business logic was not applied here. I applied here. So basically, I am getting the data very raw format from here. And there are chances that I may have to get this data and join with this data to come up with the final OPD data. Very much possible. So I'm getting the raw data from here, doing the business processes. During this business processes, there are chances that I may join this data with join this data, or maybe let's say I will join this data with census data and then analyze something, or maybe I create a different data, which is like combination of this data and this data, which actually required by this OPD team. Basically, OPD team wants to know how many patients are coming in, plus what is the population of my city, and then I want to analyze the data, right? So in that case, this is my OPD data. This is my census data. I am joining it and putting in OPD. Very much possible. So that data I am getting in. So from this raw data, I am transforming it, and then I am putting in data warehouse. And then I am further splitting it to the business type, like based on the subject area. Now, if this OPD data is helping me to run in the upstream application, for example, billing, as I mentioned, right? if this OPD data I am passing to the downstream application, which is billing, then we name it as data mart. So basically data mart is used for fetching the data from the data mart to further applications, new applications, downstream applications. However, there is a different terminology called a semantic layer, which is exactly same as data mart, no difference. The only difference is that semantic layer will be used for reporting. It's just a name, technical term, but actually both are same. There is no difference. So if your budget is more, if your technical budget is more, then you can create data mart and semantic layer both, because it's like duplicate data only. I'm putting in data mart also. I'm putting in semantic layer also. Semantic layer we use for reporting purposes, and data mart we use for future applications or downstream applications. If my budget is not more, then I can go with single. I can go with data mart and I can use this for upstream application and reporting both. That is perfectly fine. Right? So purely based on the budget. Suppose I have huge budget, I want everything should be segregated. If you are using for reporting, connect to semantic layer. If you are doing some applications, connect to data marts. But suppose I have a new company and I have a limited budget, I can create a data mart. I can use for reporting also. I can use for future application or downstream application also. So let's say, let's assume that our company is very small. We are okay with data mart. Now data mart also are of three types. One is independent. Second is dependent. Third is logical. Independent is what? Suppose if some changes are happening here. If some changes are happening here, still I will able to use this OPD data for my application. It is independent. So nothing will happen here till the time the changes are happening in the data warehouse. If the changes are happening in the data warehouse, this data is not getting impacted, then obviously I will say that this is an independent data mart. But let's say this data mart is impacted. Suppose some changes is happening here. Automatically, some issues happened here as well, because some changes are happening here. Till the time this particular data warehouse will update, I will not able to use the data mart. Once it is updated successfully, then only I will be able to use the data mart. Then this is known as dependent data mart. And third is logical. So basically I am not creating a separate data mart. I am putting data mart inside the data warehouse only. So it's a logical data mart. Basically I am creating a lot of views. We'll talk about views. So it is logically built, and it is fetching the data from different tables in the data warehouse. Logically, some logics is built inside it. And if something goes wrong here, obviously this will also not available. Once my data is fully updated here, everything is fine, then only this data mart will help me to do some future processes like reporting. So basically, this is the three type of data marts we have. One is independent, second is dependent, third is logical. These are the three types of data marts. Data marts is a subset of data warehouse, which is segregated based on the subjects. Till this point, any questions to you guys? Are you guys able to understand what's going on here? There are a lot of buzzwords going on, right? Data scientist, data engineer, BI professional. Everyone wants to become data scientist, right? Everyone wants to become BI professional. But where will you stand here? Where your job role will be, right? So basically, if I am now, let's say I want to get into IT company and I'm a fresher. Now, why I always say in to my students that if you learn Tableau and SQL, you will be good to get into a company. I saw a lot of people who want to learn artificial intelligence in this current batch only. I have a lot of students who want to learn artificial intelligence. They want to learn Python. They want to learn R. They want to learn Power BI. They want to learn Tableau. I always say my student, learn two things, but it should be perfect. Once you get into the company, that is the main priority. Then you learn after that. If you learn multiple things, your brain will be like very much cluttered, right? A lot of things in a small brain, very difficult to handle. Why I always say learn Tableau? Why? Because I'll just help you understand. Now this Tableau or Power BI, no doubt about that. But I prefer Tableau because it's my personal favorite. And SQL. When you are creating a data warehouse, and in this entire cycle, right? This will be the entire cycle. Once you know SQL and Tableau, you are actually capturing this entire thing. Only this part will be not taken care because we don't know any ETL tool. But if you know SQL, if something goes wrong in this Tableau report, you have to analyze why the data is coming wrong. You have to write a lot of queries. Where will you write the query? You will write the query here. Let's say I am having an OPD data. I am creating a Tableau report for OPD data. In that case, I want to hit this OPD data mart and write a query to check why this report is giving me wrong information. So SQL is must. Tableau, you already have a good understanding. And if you have an idea how my data warehouse project runs, you are good to go to get a job. Right? So if you have a good understanding of Tableau and good understanding of SQL, then we are good to go. But this should be perfect. Perfect means 100% perfect. You should have the clear-cut understanding of these two things. Now, I'll come to the jobs. Now here you will get a job as a data analyst, BI analyst, right? All those type of jobs you will get with these two tools plus SQL. Obviously SQL is must when you are getting into data world. Without SQL you are nothing. Second is, here you will get a job of data engineer, where you will clean the data, transform the data, understand the business logic and all those things. The data engineer people do this. To maintain this data warehouse, right? There is a data DBA jobs, database administrator. Obviously, this is these days there are a lot of managed databases available. So this job opportunities are very less. This job opportunities are very less. So I will obviously not go with what's going on. I will not obviously go with this opportunity that you go give me, man, guys. Okay. So I will not tell you guys to look for your career here. Obviously, a lot of opportunities are not here. If you know any ETL tool, now there are a lot of ETL tools, Informatica. Then we have Alteryx, which is again very much in demand. I'll write all the names later on in a notepad for you. Informatica, Alteryx, BODS, and a lot of other tools are there. So we can learn any one of the tools and you will get this data engineer job. Or if you have a SQL understanding, so SQL can be used also in this particular part in some of the companies. So that ETL thing people are using through SQL also. So you can see the power of SQL. SQL, you know, then you are actually eligible for this part of the job as well. So data engineer comes here. Here we have BI, data analyst, all those things comes in here. Here we comes up with data scientist. Now from here, OPD, let's say I want to analyze my existing data. When I want to analyze my existing data, in that case, you will require Tableau, Power BI type of tools, right? Analyzing the existing data is known as descriptive analytics. Suppose I have my business and I want to see what all sales I am having in different regions. Then descriptive analytics comes into picture. But I want to do some predictions now, right? I want to know what is the house price. I want to know how many patients will come next month. What will be the revenue next month? I am doing some predictions. Then predictive analytics comes into picture. So this data science word comes in the market for last 3, 4, 5 years because people are now more doing this predictive analytics. Why? Because my storing capacity cost is reduced drastically. I can store lots and lots of data, right, with few dollars. Processing power increased drastically, 32 GB RAM, 64 GB RAM, and so on. So when we have good processing power, when we have a good amount of data capacity for storing, then why will I not go and do some predictions? I can do that, right? That is why this predictive analytics comes into picture. But before 5 years, we used to do only this part of the work. Right? Only this part. This part only we used to do. And this is like a bread and butter for any IT company. Any business, right? They want to analyze their existing data. You will have huge amount of job opportunities here. Huge. That is why the reason I told you guys, learn Tableau, learn SQL, you are through. If you don't know Python, if you don't know anything, we are okay with that. You will get a job. Python is just an edge for you guys. And obviously, if you know these things, then obviously your market value will high. Why not? But do you know Tableau? 100%. Do you know SQL? The current answer is no, right? We don't know it. So how much good you are in Tableau, how much good you are in SQL is what matters, the first thing to get a job. After that, Python and other things, they will think of. Now, once this is done, now what else we have? Now, this is a data warehouse architecture where we explained everything, right? ODS, then ETL, then data warehouse, then data marts. And for BI, I have this part. If I want to do some prediction, then I put the data here. I'll do some predictive analytics. This is my entire data warehouse architecture. Now, how many of you guys heard about data lakes? How many of you guys heard about data lakes? I saw a lot of people are very much curious enough to learn a lot of things. How many of you guys heard about data lakes? Anyone? Question arises, how we will create data warehouse? Suppose I have a company. Let's discuss as a very layman. Okay, guys, I don't want to get into technical now. Just first understand the concept. I started my company. I'm very small company and I have a limited budget. I don't have any funding or nothing. Let's say me and Milind started a company. I will ask question to Milind only as a technical expert now. So Milind, we want to maintain the data, right? And we don't have manpower. We don't have manpower and we don't have money also. Will we go ahead and create the data warehouse or will we ask someone to create the data warehouse for us? We don't have money. Data warehouse will give me a lot of cost. Shall I go ahead and ask them to create a data warehouse? And my business is very small, guys. Daily, I have, let's say, 1,000 records coming in. 1,000 transactions happens, nothing else. Shall I go ahead with creating a data warehouse? Milind is saying no. What about others? No, obviously. Because I don't have budget, right? I don't have budget. How will I go and create a data warehouse? Not possible. What will I do? I will start creating the Excel files. Simple. sasta tikau, right? Let's say I am taking care of the, let's say we are into a training. I am taking care of the Python training. Milind is taking care of the Tableau training. And let's say Mahima is taking care of the SQL training. So what we will do? Mahima will take care of the SQL students. She will start putting the data on the Excel file for the SQL student. She will maintain a separate Excel file. Milind will maintain the separate Excel file for Tableau. I will maintain the separate Excel file for Python. That is what we will do. Yes or no? Now, can I say that SQL is one subject area? Tableau is one subject area? Python is one subject area? Can I say that for my business? Because I have three verticals. So these are three subject areas for me. Right? Now, let me come to the second slide first of all. Yeah, this is. So can I say that I have three subject areas? Tableau, Python, and SQL. What I will do, I will ETL. So basically ETL is like, suppose let's say I want to transform the data. I am getting the Excel file, but then I am making some changes. Let's say Mahima has one intern who is entering the data. I have one intern who is entering the data. And Milind has one intern entering the data. And once he is entering, let's say Milind has an intern Rakshit, I have an intern Kushal, and Mahima has an intern, let's say Sneha, right? Now, Rakshit populated something. Milind is his manager. He is checking the data and he is doing some modification in the data and putting in a data mart. So Milind is using this data. He made some changes. Milind says that I don't want first name and last name. I just want a name. So let's modify the data. Rakshit is putting the data as a first name, last name. Let me modify the data and put it in my data mart. So I will use this data for my analysis. Same way here. Let's say I just want some transformation. I want some changes in the data. Let's say I have Python. Now I am Python. I am teaching Python for data science, machine learning, and AI. Let's say, but Kushal is maintaining all the data together. So what I am saying him that you are putting all the data together, but try to add one more column in this ETL process where I will segregate the data based on the courses. One is for data science, one is for machine learning, one is for AI. So what he will do, he will, from this data, he will do some business logic, apply one extra column and create a new data mart, which will have one extra column, which says the course name. So what happened from this raw data, he added one new column with the logic. With that logic, he created a new data mart with extra column, which is nothing but course name, so that it will help me to understand what course which student belongs to. Same way with Mahima. Sneha did some data entering here. There is some logic which Mahima wants. Let's say SQL and PLSQL. She wants to segregate the data. So Sneha did that through ETL and a new data mart is created. So now you're understanding it. What's happening here? I am a very small business. I am just saving the data in Excel file, doing little bit of transformation manually, and then putting in a data mart. But over the period of time, my business increased drastically, right? Now we have thousands and thousands of students in each of the courses. We have a lot of revenue coming in. And now it is very difficult for me to maintain it. ETL processes which I have created, it was a manual process. I put some logic, Excel. I created some Excel macro, which is helping me to apply the logic, but it is not scalable. I have more than 10 lakh records. I will not be able to handle that in Excel. The data mart which I have created, maybe in Excel or let's say in Oracle, I'm not able to handle it. I need some more space. I need some more business logic here so that my time will be saved. Then I will connect, because my budget is now more. Then I will connect to some IT company and I will say that, hey, this is my business and this is my different data marts, and I want to create a data warehouse where I will actually save the entire data. And finally, I want a single report where I will have Tableau, Python and SQL consolidated. I can, me, Mahima and Milind are now directors, and we want to analyze the overall business, because now we are not teaching. We have a lot of trainers under us, and we are now analyzing the data and trying to understand what's going on. So I want a single consolidated report, which will help me to analyze my data. Then I have budget. I'll ask my IT team to create a data warehouse. So here, what happened? From the raw data, data mart created, then data warehouse created. Bottom approach. Bottom up approach. Okay. From data mart to data warehouse to reporting is bottom up approach. But let's take another scenario where I have a huge budget initially. I want to start my business, and I got the funder. I got a lot of funding from the venture capital funds. Now, what will be the approach? Then I will say, okay, I have the sources. Create an ETL robust application. Create a data warehouse. Then I will create a data mart where each data mart belongs to individual subject area, and then we'll do the report. So this is known as top-down approach. So when we are creating a data warehouse project, there are chances in your real-time application, real-time work, there are chances that you may have to work in a top-down approach, or you may have to work in a bottom-up approach. When I was in Deloitte, at that point in time, there was a client called CNO Financials. They had the bottom-up approach. They had a lot of data from different sources. They have Excel, they have MS Access, and a lot of things. And they wanted to create a data warehouse in Oracle. We created for them. So that was a bottom-up approach. There was a bank called Nordea when I was in Sweden. At that time, they wanted us to create data warehouse and then data mart. That was a top-down approach. So it is purely based on the budget of a company, which approach they will go for, whether it will be top-down or bottom-up. Is that clear to all of you? Are you guys understanding, able to relate the things? What's going on here? Is this helping you guys? Learning something new? All right. Now, data lake. Now, data lake is a new term. Like data science is a new term, right? Same way data lake is a new term. They are like, in IT, they are like, they want to just come up with a fancy words, right? The concept is very simple. Now, what is data lake? During the training, I told you many times that I gave you this example also. When I was working for Deloitte, there was a client called Celgene. We are getting data from various different data sources, right? I told this multiple times. So basically what they wanted was, they are capturing data from, let's say Optum is one source, then FDA is one source. They are capturing all the data. And then they will process the data if they require it. What companies are doing now? They have a lot of storing capacity. If suppose you have a lot of storing capacity, you will take a lot of things, and then you will use those things once you will require it, right? Same way in the data lake as well. Data lake is like a different approach of these days people are using. I have ODS. ODS is here, nothing means. Let's say I'm getting data from IoT. People are talking about IoT, right? A lot of apps is generating the data. I want to get the data. Let's say I'm into restaurant business, and I want to get the data from Magic Pin. Right? So they are capturing a lot of restaurant data. So I will ask them, please supply that data to me. I want to analyze for my business. So I'm getting the data from IoT. It's IoT, right? Because it's capturing from the app and it's real-time data. I'm capturing it. Perfect. Then I'll go to, let's say, some of the vendors who are providing my competitors' data. So I will ask them, I will pay money to you. You give me the competitors' data. So that is one source. Then I will have my own data. My own business data, right? So I'm capturing the data from various different data sources and putting that in data lake, guys. For example, here I took the example of life sciences. Optum is one of the source. So basically, there is a company called United Health Group. United Health Group. So this company generates the data called Optum. So it's like one type of data, right? It's like one type of data. If you see here, Optum is committed to provide best health services, leading way to better experiences. They generate a lot of data. Similarly, we have FDA data also. I shared this data to US many times. FAERS database. This data, right? So this is also one of the data which we use. So this consists of a lot of patients' data and all this. Like suppose I am taking a drug, then what side effect happened to me and all those things. So that data is captured here. It's a quarterly file, so you can play around with this. Those guys who know Tableau, you can play around with this data. So it's a quarterly file they maintain. Similarly, there is a Worldometer website. So there is a Worldometer website. Here I get a lot of data on coronavirus population in the different countries. It's an amazing website. Amazing website. So we are getting data from here also, right? Then there are other websites also. So what I'm doing is I'm capturing all the data and putting in my data lake. Now it's up to me now whether I want to use FDA data for analysis, or I want to do Worldometer for analysis, or I want to use Optum data for analysis is up to me now. As and when I require the data, I will pick the data and play around with it. So data lake is nothing but I am putting the raw data in my data lake, and as per my requirement, I will apply the ETL, process the data, and do the analysis. Are you guys understanding it? So basically, data warehouse, data lake. In data warehouse, my data is clean. And then I am doing analysis. In data lake, my data is raw. And then I am cleaning. And then I am doing analysis. And this is the latest thing which people are doing in the industry. The benefit is cost is less. I don't have to create the data warehouse, right? I have raw data. Suppose I am interested in the population data. I connected Worldometer, do some processing, and then doing the analysis. Done. Very less cost. But suppose my business is very huge and I have a lot of budget, then I can come up with some more new type of technique. Data lake and warehouse. I have a data lake, raw data. I am doing some ETL processing. After that, I am creating a data warehouse, guys. So I have a data lake as per my requirement. I pick the data, do some processing, putting it in data warehouse, and then I am doing analysis by segregating to further data marts. But here you will obviously understand, right? A lot of cost will be there. I have to first create a data lake, a cost. I have to do some ETL processes, a cost. I have to write the logic, right? I need an ID professionals for that. So it's a cost. Then I have to maintain the data warehouse. It's a cost. From there, I am creating the different data marts. It's a cost. And then obviously reporting and analytics. It's a cost. However, if you see, in the previous example, the cost is very less. No data warehouse, no data marts, nothing. We just fetch the data, put the raw data here, analyze that, do some transformation in the data, and then analyze the data. Simple. So data lake architecture is nothing but get the raw data, play around with it, and done. If your budget is more, you can go with this type of approach also. It will be more robust. It will be more beautiful. But again, it is a cost. Did you guys understand the raw data and data lake and data warehouse? Now in data lake, we can have unstructured data as well. I have a text file, I have unstructured data because it's a raw data. In data warehouse, my data will be structured. It cannot be unstructured. So suppose, let's say I'm having a log files or I'm having a Twitter tweets, right? I'm fetching all the Twitter tweets, analyze, like doing some transformation, and then I'm making it as a table. So from the raw data, which is a Twitter tweets, I'm doing some processing, making my data clean and structured table, and put that in data warehouse. And then I will do analysis. So in my data lake, I can have unstructured. I will have, obviously, unstructured, because a lot of unstructured data they are generating now. So I have unstructured data here. From here, I can very well play around and transform and then do the reportings and analytics, obviously. Is this architecture clear to all of you? Any questions till this point before I proceed? These are some text. I want you guys to go through it. It's a simple text. I'll show you an image. It's a courtesy Grazity.com data warehouse versus data lake. It's a beautiful infographic they have created. Now in data warehouse, data is processed and organized into a single schema before being put into warehouse. The analysis is done on the clean data in the warehouse. That is what we discussed. In data lake, raw and unstructured data goes into data lake. Data is selected and organized as and when needed. That is the data lake. Okay, so that is very, very important difference between data warehouse and data lake. In interview, you can tell that I know data warehouse, I know data lake, and you can give the answer. Okay, now there is a concept of OLTP and OLAP, online transaction processing, online analytical processing. Now, what is online transaction processing? Well, what is online analytical processing? Do you guys go to ATM machine and fetch out the money? Do you guys apply for mini statements? Right? Yes or no? So if you go to ATM and if you'll ask for mini statement, if mini statement will generate after 2 hours, will you enjoy the experience? No, right? So when we are talking about OLTP, it's a transaction processing. Number of records are less. If you go to ATM and you will say, okay, I need last 6 years of transactions, will ATM give it to you? No, right? ATM will give you last 10 transactions maximum. However, when you want last 6 years of transactions, then OLAP type of transactions comes into picture. Online analytical processing. Now, what is the difference? Let's try to understand. Basically, in OLTP, my data volume is less. In OLAP, my data volume is high. Suppose I want to analyze my past 6 years of data, how my business is growing over the period of time, or I want to do some analytics, online analytical processing, right? Huge amount of data, I'm analyzing it. Then OLAP system comes into picture. But suppose I need a quick outputs, mini statements, transactions, and a lot of things. In that case, I will have online transaction processing because the number of records are less. Okay, so OLTP is nothing but when you want the quicker output. OLAP is nothing but when you want the more historical understanding. Right? You want to understand how the things was over the period of time and how now it is. So when you have huge data, when you want huge analysis, then we go with OLAP systems. But when we want quick outputs, then OLTP comes into picture. All right. Perfect. Any questions till this point?